Tell you, let's do this shit now. I'll be right back, I'm finishing.
Okay, it's open. Let's go, Wake.
Why?
Well, it's tradition. We're almost there. We'll have to go through the basement to get to the parking lot.
Yeah, there's no way going through the crypt will turn out to be a bad idea. Christmas lights for?
Protection, man. Like garlic against vampires.
Vampires.
The helicopter's just across the parking lot and up the hill. Come on.
Bright Falls General Store is now my favorite place in the entire world. See this headlamp? It's like a superpower. I can just look at one of those things and they die. It's my flaming eye of Mordor.
I wish I didn't say that.
Hey, I want a headlamp.
Last one.
Bastard.
Oh, hell yeah. I cannot believe it.
When someone throws a damn school bus at your head and you're about to take a helicopter ride with someone who may or may not have a pilot's license, you're cleared for departure.
helicopter's just up ahead. I'll need a while to prep for takeoff.
Don't take too long.
I
want to get out of
back. Go. You did? Yeah, here we are. Nice. Come on. I'll be right back. Here we are. Okay, nice. Guess let's head towards the bloody power plant or whatever. Shit. Oh crap.
Here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of our local rock legends, the old gods. I couldn't tell you why. I guess it's just one of those things. Anyway, here's Poets of the Fall and their latest single, War.
Come on, I have to make it to go this way, there's a safe haven. Huh. Suck shit, cunt. You stupid bitch.
The power plant glowed at night. It was close, but I had to find a way across.
Can't you just swim? Or something? What, can't you just swim or something? Over there, maybe? What, can't you? I know there's stuff in there, but in the water, but can't you just swim? Like, fuck. Like normal people? Can't you just swim? What the fuck, dude, can't you? This is why, you know, can't you just bloody swim? Because this shit. I'll be right back when I finish it.
You can help me. About time. Young man, I've been waiting a very long time for you. It's in the well-lit room.
Excuse me?
What you need to drive the darkness back. The well-lit room is at the dam. I built the room to keep it safe.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
We won't go outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. You've been breaking the rules, young man, and where has that gotten us, hmm? I found a secret route, a lit route, a warm water pipe. Something was damaged at the transformer yard. Power. Without it, the pipe will go dark. The power to the yard must be cut.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules. I can't be outside in the dark. The kill switch is outside. I have been preparing for these times, the dark tides. I've my ashes, haven't you? You can see the signs. Very few people. Please, take what you need. This is all for you, for the likes of us. We do Tom's work, don't we?
Hurry! The switch is on the wall facing the shore.
the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it. If I could figure out the gates, I could use them to get to the kill switch.
This is impossible to do this. How though? Like, how? Is it this way? This way then? Maybe, because if I can get up there, I can climb over. No. Okay. So, how do I bloody do this? I can't enter the gate. The gate is locked for some reason. If no, I fucking bloody, you know. Okay, good. So it's not impossible. Finally.
Ooh. The transformer yard went dark and weird. Neither
Nope. Fuck. Fucking bitch. I'll be right back.
Come, the pipe's empty now. We're ready to go. This way. We need to go.
I knew them both. Come on. Barbara, I had such a crush on him. Such a beautiful man. I was jealous. There was a part of me that was maybe a little glad when she had the accident. And then Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring it back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. Which looked like her.
But it wasn't. Barbara was sweet.
He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. He was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. He left only one thing behind him, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I couldn't refuse him. I built a well-lit room in my den. It's been waiting for you.
We are characters trapped in a story. None of us will survive to see the end of the darkness isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to her own audience.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me.
Beyond, from below, we've both been touched by the darkness, young man. He seen and spoke like the darkness stays with you. You sustain. This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
Is Sarah there?
Be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it. At least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.
Thank you.
How many of them are there? Where'd that one go? This can't be happening. This is really bad.
Was that it? Are we safe?
That was... wow. I think we're okay.
Hey, Al, I got a bad feeling.
Let's keep our eyes open.
Please, Al, let's just stay here where it's safe.
Wait, call the elevator. I'm keeping watch.
I hear something moving around.
Heads up, here they come.
Oh no!
Oh,
Something Zane left behind. Something to fix this.
Gee, could you be a little more vague?
Thomas Zane? Seriously? Might as well be Paul Bunyan or Bigfoot.
Yeah, well, he was real.
Let's be careful, okay?
So we can get in.
We'll be right back.
Changing soon, and I don't want to climb up the ladder to change them because it's very late and I'm tired. And if you take it, I won't have to do that anymore.
The page was autobiographical, a memory from my childhood. But I didn't write this. It was a page written by Thomas Zane. None of them were supposed to exist anymore.
Alan, 7 years old, would fight sleep to the bitter end. When he did sleep, he soon woke up, screaming, with nightmares fresh in his mind. One evening, his mother, sitting by his bed, offered him an old light switch. She called it the clicker, and flicking the switch would turn on a magical light that would drive the beast away. To imbue the talisman with all possible power, she added that it had been given to her by Alan's father. Alan never knew him, and anything of his took on mythical proportions in his mind. With the clicker firmly in his hand, Alan finally slept like a baby. Now, almost 30 years later, Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
My mind swirled. I'd given the clicker to Alice, yet it was here. Zane had written it into existence in a story I had written. I can get to her now. I can finish this. Previously on Alan Wake, I wrote a horror story that has come true. Thomas Zane did the same in the 70s.
You will go no further.
If I continue like the Dark Presence wants me to, the story I'm writing won't save Alice. It's a horror story. No one will survive.
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song!
He left something behind to help me. The clicker.
Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
I can get to her now. I can finish this. Sunglasses and painkillers to dull the pain. In one of my finer moments of self-deception, I swore to quit drinking. The pills worked fast. The prospect of being awake started to seem bearable again. Were like needles in my eyes. I needed my sunglasses. The sunglasses made the world look bearable. Now I could keep my eyes open without feeling like a vampire in the sun. There was a message waiting for me on the machine. I've been a guest on a talk show the previous night, talking about my latest book. The show was supposed to be waiting for me last night.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. We have a great show tonight. I've been talking with best-selling author Alan Wake about his new book, The Sudden Stop. It is a good read. I'm going to be honest here. Is that wise? No, but I'm going to do it anyway. I got people who give me the lowdown on books. I'm a busy guy. But this one, I actually read from cover to cover. I mean, I'm a big fan. Wow, thanks. Now, this might be a spoiler for those who haven't read the book yet, based on the sales figures, the two people out there who haven't read the book yet. But this last book is all about the death of the main character, the hard-boiled New York detective, Alex Casey. Now, there's been a lot of outrage about it. Why the hell did you kill Casey? What the hell were you thinking, man?
Good riddance.
No, seriously, though. 7 years and 6 books is a long time. He was a gloomy guy to spend all your working hours with, and it was a good run. But it's time to explore new things. My next book will be a departure from the old for me. You selfish bastard. Always thinking of yourself. You've certainly given us a lot of entertainment over. Now that you mention it, Casey was a gloomy guy. Never had much luck with his love life with a lady. Was that autobiographical in any way?
Yeah, no kidding. Casey's lady friends tended to die on
him. It was all about his pain.
No, nothing autobiographical about that. I'm a happily married man. My wife is my muse.
Well, congratulations. That's great to hear. So, how's the publicity tour been treating you?
Good. Great. But I gotta say, I'm glad to be back home in New York.
Well, you've certainly been on the news a lot lately. Lots of parties and, you got into a fight with some paparazzi.
Oh, man. Well, that guy was really in my face. I lost my temper. I know that wasn't cool.
You are famous for that temper.
Well, I did also write several books.
This novel is called The Sudden Stop, and it's in bookstores now. Go get it. That means the two of you out there have it fun. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for you tonight. I want to thank all our guests for the